how to operate the DPH camera correctly. Hello everyone and welcome to today's video. We will delve into the proper usage of DTH hammers. This critical technique not only impacts work efficiency, but also directly affects job safety and equipment lifespan. As industry leaders, we focus on providing efficient and reliable solutions. If you have any questions or want to learn more, please click the homepage link in the video description. You can connect with us via WhatsApp for real-time communication or fill out the contact form. We are here to assist you. Now, let's explore the key steps to correctly using DTH hammers together. How to operate the DTH hammer? What are the methods of operating the impactor? Ranking introduces the correct operation method and precautions of the drilling tool during use. The impactor we refer to is also called the pneumatic impactor and the wind-driven down-the-hole hammer. A bottom-bottom power tool that uses compressed air as a power medium to generate continuous impact loads using the energy of compressed air. Compressed air can also double as a washing medium. So how do you operate the impactor correctly? Do you understand these things? If you don't know, you can check out this article. 1. To ensure sufficient working pressure. When the impactor is barely working under the condition of the specified working pressure, the impact energy and frequency will be reduced, so that the rock cannot be effectively broken and the drilled slag can be effectively discharged out of the hole in time, so that the rock drilling speed is sharp. Decreased, the wear of the bit is intensified and the cost of drilling is greatly increased, so it is absolutely impossible to work under the specified working pressure. 2. Choose a reasonable speed. When selecting the speed
Here's what
of
the drill bits look like. Not your average drill bit. They're made of tungsten carbide, types. Which is a very hard metal, and they're hollow to allow air to be pumped down through the center and out the bottom.
The distance between two adjacent chisels is larger. That is, the rotation speed is higher. Otherwise, if the rock has poor chimerity, the rotation speed should be selected lower. 3. Maintain a certain axial pressure. The axial pressure applied to the impactor is preferably such that the impactor does not cause a rebound phenomenon when working. When the axial pressure is too large, the load on the rock with poor chimerity will increase the load of the rotary mechanism, and the accident of damaging the rotary mechanism and the drill pipe will occur, and the wear of the drill will be accelerated. When working on a rock, it will cause a pinch accident due to drilling too fast. 4. To ensure reliable lubrication. Every time a well is drilled, the impactor should be disassembled and cleaned, and a certain amount of hydraulic oil or mechanical oil should be added after assembly. The lubricating oil of the impactor is made of number 20 mechanical oil in summer and 510 mechanical oil or number 5 spindle oil in winter. 5. To ensure that the gas path is clean and smooth. Before the impactor is installed on the rig, the rear joint hole should be temporarily blocked to prevent foreign matter from falling in. The drill pipe should be blown before the impactor is connected. 6. The drill is strictly prohibited to reverse. Both the drill pipe and the impactor are threaded, and reversal can cause a hole drop accident. Therefore, it is strictly forbidden to reverse the drilling tool during work. When the drill pipe is disassembled, the inner part of the hole is not allowed to reverse. 7. Do not stop the gas supply before stopping the drill. When drilling to the predetermined well depth and stopping drilling, the gas supply to the impactor should not be stopped immediately, so as to prevent the slag that has not been discharged outside the hole from falling to the bottom of the hole to cause the drilling accident to be caused by the sudden stop of gas. Instead, the impactor should be lifted slightly off the bottom of the well, so that the impactor stops the impact and the slag is strongly perched. When the orifice is not in the slag and the rock dust is discharged, the gas is stopped, and then the drill is lowered and the rotation is stopped. 8. Appropriate control of water supply. When performing wet rock drilling operations, the water that enters the impactor should be properly controlled. Generally, it is advisable not to use dry rock powder or mud. 9. Change the bit to pay attention to the diameter change. After the bit is worn, the new bit is not available when the hole is not drilled. Replace the old drill head to avoid pinching due to the new drill head diameter being larger than the drilled hole diameter. Thank you for watching this episode. If you have any questions about the correct usage of DTH hammers or would like to learn more, feel free to click the homepage link in the video description. You can connect with us in real time via WhatsApp or fill out a simple contact form. By clicking the link, you can also receive free product information and the latest quotations. We look forward to interacting with you and providing more customized solutions.